Hey guys, JV here bringing you another Destiny 2 tips and tricks video, and this time we're looking at another exotic quest for one of the best PvP weapons out there right now. Just a heads up, this is your place for daily Destiny 2 content here on YouTube, so hit that subscribe button and stay tuned for Destiny 2 tips and tricks videos. Today I'm going to show you how to get the Mida Multi-Tool Exotic Scout Rifle. Returning from the original game, this thing is an absolute powerhouse kinetic weapon. Let's take a look. Instead of waiting around for Xur or an exotic engram like the first game, the Mida is obtained through an exotic weapon quest. After you hit level 20 and beat the story, you'll find the Enhance world quest near Devrim K in the EDZ. This one has a recommended power level of 260, but my personal recommendation is that you wait as long as possible for the Mida because, of course, the longer you wait, the higher attack it will be. And quick side note, if you haven't done this already, start saving up rare or better scout rifles. Towards the end of this quest, you'll need 5 of them, and it really sucks to have to wait and grind for them at that step, so I wouldn't even start until you have 5 of those. So, you'll need to complete Enhance in order to get the Mida Multi-Tool, which requires a lot of strange random steps and may take an hour or so to finish, so prepare for that time. They involve stopping the Fallen from making enhanced ether, using explosives to detonate barriers, basically a lot of errand running around the EDZ. Periodically, you'll be asked to return to Devrim for the next step. After the first few, he'll give you the legendary Mida Mini Tool, which is actually a very strong submachine gun that you'll probably be infusing up later on. I love to use it with my Mida Multi-Tool, and it should drop a few attack points higher than your current power level like mine did. Once you have the Mini Tool, you'll need to go to the tower and speak with Banshee the Gunsmith, that someone will be returning to several times for the rest of this quest. He'll give you the next step, called Sight, Shoot, Repeat, which involves a series of weapon challenges you'll need to do with a scout rifle. The first set of challenges is to kill 50 enemies with precision shots and kill 3 enemies without reloading 25 separate times. You'll need to repeat the 3 enemies 25 different times to get that one, and you can track your progress using the quest item in your kinetic weapon slot category. This is fairly simple. Equip a scout rifle and find an area with a high volume of enemies who respawn fairly quickly. And honestly, my best advice is to just go back to where Devrim K is, Trossland in the EDZ. Just make sure there aren't a lot of other players nearby stealing your kills. If you do run into that, open the map and fast travel to the same spot, the same location, in order to refresh the instance. That's a little trick so that you can have all of the enemies for yourself. Once you finish that, the item will update in your inventory and ask you to return to Banshee. Now he'll give you another item called Under the Hood, which asks you to dismantle 5 valuable scout rifles, which just means rare quality or better. You can do legendary ones if you'd like, just make sure it's not one of the really good ones that you want to save and infuse up later. So, as I mentioned, this step is a pain if you haven't already saved those scout rifles, if you haven't gotten rare ones and thrown them in your vault at the tower. So, if you find yourself in that position, try to complete activities that drop the most blue items. My advice is to roam around the EDZ doing public events, looting lost sectors, looting those region chests if they've reset, and killing high value targets. Once you've dismantled 5 valuable scout rifles, return to Banshee once again. This time he'll hand you the final quest item and the final challenge, and it asks you to get 50 submachine gun kills while in midair. This seems difficult, but as of September 21st, 2017, when I'm recording this video, there's a simple way to trick the game into thinking that you're airborne when you're actually not. As long as you're standing on an object that is above ground level, whether it's a rock, stacked boxes, anything like that, your kills will actually count as being airborne when you're really not. So, for this part, I traveled to the Exodus Black location on Nessus, but I bet you can do this anyway. As long as the environment has rocks and boxes and lets you. Ideally, you'll want plenty of enemies spawning so you don't have to run out of things to shoot and, you know, find other objects to hop on and shoot enemies, stuff like that. So, public events are perfect for this step. Find one, travel to that location on the map, jump on some elevated objects, and start killing. This part probably took me the longest because, you know, you run out of enemies, public events don't last that long, you don't have 50 that you'll get in one, for example. But if you get lucky with event areas frequently popping up, it can happen very quickly. Once you get 50 airborne kills, the quest will update, you'll see that, and you'll be able to return to Banshee for your reward. The Mida Multi-Tool is an exotic scout rifle, which goes in your kinetic weapon slot. As far as scout rifles go, the Mita has a little higher than average impact, decent range and stability, but it really shines with its handling and reload speed. Fire rate and magazine size are nothing to write home about, but the time it takes to pull up and ready this weapon is so incredibly quick, just one of the reasons why it's so good in Crucible game modes. The Mita's intrinsic perk is named after the weapon itself, Mita Multitool. This weapon boosts movement speed. It just feels like you're gliding around with this weapon equipped. I really love this intrinsic perk. Having additional speed is such an advantage in PvP modes. When you need to run between points, grab a crest in Supremacy, or revive a teammate, running faster is just better. The trait perk is Mita Radar. Radar stays active while aiming down sights. Once again, this is so good for any situation where you need additional awareness. Obviously, in Crucible, you have a distinct advantage being able to look at the radar while aiming down sights, because not everyone is using the Mita, and if you're not, you can't do that. Actually, correction, a lot of people are using the Mita right now, so if you don't have it, then you're at a distinct disadvantage. Even in the raid, for example, when it's your specific job to clear out mobs, this allows you to keep an eye on where they are at all times. So this trait might even be more powerful than the intrinsic perk. It's great. So how good is the Mita Multitool? Very strong. In fact, 95% of matches during the first weekend of trials featured at least one Mita. So if that doesn't tell you what the current Crucible meta is, I don't know what does. If you want to be competitive in PvP right now, hands down, you need the Mita. And I'm uploading this on a Thursday. Trials is about to start. So if you haven't gotten it already, you should definitely use this guide and pick it up for the weekend. I use it along with the mini tool as my kinetic and energy weapons in PvE too. They're both must-have weapons as far as I'm concerned. Alright guys, today I showed you how to get the Mita Multitool. In the comment section below, tell me what you think of the Mita as an exotic. Like I said, it's in my current loadout because I love it so much and it's so strong in PvP right now. So share your thoughts in the comment section below. Next time we will cover more Destiny 2 here on the channel, so stay tuned for daily Destiny 2 tips and tricks videos. If you learned something new, remember to hit that like button and subscribe for lots of Destiny 2 content. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll talk to you next time.